guys. Hello, gorgeous. Got a fun one to review today, courtesy of Alpha. It's their new Drone Force. They come in four different sizes with different price points ranging from $24.99 to $79.99. Today we'll be looking at one of the larger size drones, the Angler Attack. Nice glossy imagery with the big fish on the front. The box specifies it's suitable for indoor or outdoor use, but I'd advise either a big open space if you're using it indoors without anything fragile nearby, or if you're using it outdoors, grass would be a good idea to break the fall of any nosedives. You'll need a non-windy day too. The age recommendation is 8 and up, and a warning about small parts and choking hazards. Three AAA batteries are required for the controller. The Angler itself uses a USB rechargeable battery that is included. The box also shows up the Light Up gimmick and some of the other entries in the Drone Force lineup. And some flight specs. A whopping 150-foot flight range. Alright, let's release this big fish. There are some easy-to-follow instructions included on how to set it up, as well as important flight control directions. It comes secured in the box, so you'll have to cut the wraps. And since you'll probably crash a few times before you get the hang of it, Alpha has included two sets of extra propellers. And here's a look at the controller. I like how it looks and feels a lot like a PS4 or Xbox controller with the dual thumbsticks. And the green coloring reminds me of my original Xbox. Pretty lightweight too. You'll need a mini Phillips head or cross-recessed screwdriver to remove this screw to remove the battery cover to insert the three AAA batteries. You'll know if you have them in right if you see a red indicator light when you press the power button. And a rechargeable battery is included for the Angler Attack. This battery reminds me of a smaller version of an iPod battery, if you've ever taken one of those apart. Once it's fully charged, it'll go under here, and you'll need to unscrew this door as well with a mini Phillips or cross-recess screwdriver. So to charge it, you just plug it into the USB cord that's also included, and plug it into any USB port like a computer or an adapter like this one. You'll know it's charging when this red indicator light turns on, and when it's fully charged, the red light will go off. And here's another look at the spare propellers included. The Angler comes with two green and two red propellers already installed, so you get two extra green and two extra red propellers. So if they get broken on a particularly bumpy landing, you can remain color coordinated. To replace the propellers, you'll have to use a mini Phillips screwdriver to undo the screws here, 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 and here. With the battery fully charged, we'll place it inside the Angler. I found it a bit tricky to fit in there along with a short cord, so just take your time. You'll connect the battery cord to the unit cord, and then close up the battery door, slide it up to lock it in, somewhat, and then tighten the screw to secure it. And you'll know everything is charged and connected when you flip this power switch, and the Angler's eyes start flashing red. And here's a 360 view of the Angler Attack. Nice lightweight design. Light and flexible plastic, but it feels pretty durable. It's big, but not heavy. Lots of airflow here, which is necessary for liftoff. And I like that the propellers are pretty well hidden. It looks like a fish instead of a fish/helicopter hybrid. Okay, next step is to pair the controller with the Angler. We'll turn on the controller, and to pair, we press up on the left thumbstick, and we hear a beep, then down, and another beep, followed by a short beep, which indicates pairing has been achieved. And a light comes on between the Angler's eyes, also signifying successful pairing. Now you can activate the Angler's lights by pressing the right shoulder button on the controller. There are a few different modes. You can make them all come on simultaneously and slowly pulsate on and off, or come on one at a time. This will be handy for keeping track of the Angler for nighttime flying. Okay, we're charged and paired. It's time for liftoff. Disclaimer, this is my first time ever flying a drone. All right, here we go. This is awesome. I tell you, we do so much today digitally and virtually It's a real thrill to push up on a joystick and have something tangible actually rise up. The fact that I absolutely suck at this at the moment doesn't take away from my enjoyment at all. The controls require a very soft touch. They're very delicate. So just a little too much up and you'll hit the ceiling. Just a little too much to the left and you'll crash into a wall. Ideally, this is better for outside, but it's a windy day today, so I'll have to settle for this room. Thankfully, for people like me with no experience drone flying, this little fish is pretty tough. I've crashed him a few times and he's still working great. No damage to the walls I've crashed into either, although don't push your luck on that. If you keep trying and can't get the hang of the liftoff controls, there is an automatic liftoff button on the controller above the power button, so you can just dew with roll, pitch, and yaw controls. This thing is really fun! I've gotten used to having toys sitting on shelves and just enjoying them as display pieces, so this takes me back to the days of being a kid and actually playing with a toy. And not caring if it gets bashed around. I'm not very good at flight simulators, and on this thing I'm finding myself trying to invert the control since I'm so used to doing that in video games. But with enough practice, I'm starting to get the hang of it. Again, it takes me back to being a kid when I used to have to work at and learn something new. This would be a great toy for kids to test and hone their patience and focus. And they've got something tangible flying around to show for it, instead of a virtual digital representation on a TV screen or a cell phone. I love how steady this thing is once you level it out. It looks like a hummingbird. Or a green screen effect if you've got them in front of a blank wall like I do. As a drone newbie, the Angler Attack gets a big thumbs up from me. Easy to assemble and set up, and instant fun with room, lots of room, for improvement on my flying skills. Question or comment? Scroll down and go to town. And to join the tribe, hit subscribe. Nerdmaste!